Hi students, MCQ number 9. In a large building, there are 15 bulbs of 40 watts each. 5 bulbs of 100 watt each. 5 fans of 80 watt each. And 1 heater of 1000 watt, that is 1 kilowatt, are connected across a 220 volt. The maximum capacity of the fuse will be. So what is the maximum capacity of the fuse? That is the current value we are supposed to find out. So now the power of each device is given. What is the total power we have to find out? So all these devices are connected in parallel, is it not? So we have to add the power. The power in parallel is equal to the sum of these powers. So the total power P is equal to, now 15 bulb each of 40 watt. So this is 15 into 40 plus 5 bulb into 100. So this is 5 into 100 watt each plus 5 fans into 80. So this is 5 into 80 plus 1 heater of 1000 watt. So kilowatt is 1000. So this is equal to 15 fours are 60. So this is 600 plus this 500. So this is 500 plus 80 into 5 is 400 plus 1000. So if you add, means this 600 plus 400 is 1000. 1000 plus 1000 is 2000 plus 500 is 2500 watt is the total power in the parallel combination. Now the potential difference is what? 220 volt, is it not? So power P is equal to voltage into current. This implies current is equal to power divided by voltage. Therefore current is equal to power is 2500. So 2500 divided by the voltage is 220. So this is 250 divided by 22. So this is equal to 125 divided by 11. Now 11 11s are 121, we know, is it not? 11 11s are 121. So if you use a calculator, means we can find out the answer. It is something 11 point something is coming. Okay, I will find out 125. So 125 divided by 11. So this is equal to 11.4 is coming. So this is equal to 11.4 ampere is coming. So for safety purpose, the next nearest higher value we have to go. So out of this, you can see that 12 ampere is the next nearest higher value. So I can write nearly. Okay, so I is the fuse must carry a current of what? 12 ampere. This is a maximum capacity fuse, 12 ampere. So option D is correct. Okay, therefore option D is correct. Okay, now the next problem number 10 is based on the given circuit. So look at the circuit now. It consists of 3 resistors in series. So the 3 ohm resistor, 2.5 ohm resistor, and this resistor, unknown resistor, is P. They are in series, connected to a 9 volt supply, and the current supplied by the battery is given as 1 ampere. So if I is equal to 1 ampere, what is the resistance at P is the question. So for that, the first, this R equivalent is equal to, see, from Ohm's law, what is R is equal to V by I, is it not? So this is equal to V divided by I. So this is equal to 9 divided by 1 is equal to 9. So if you add the 3 resistors, 3 plus 2.5, 5.5 plus P. So the R equivalent is what? 3 plus 2.5 plus P. This is equal to 9. So 5.5 plus P is equal to 9. So P is equal to 9 minus 5.5, that is equal to 3.5 ohm. So out of the given options, option C is the correct answer. Okay, so this is option C is correct. Option C is the correct answer. Now, similar problem is number 11, based on the circuit. In the circuit, you can see three equal resistors of 15 ohm each are connected in parallel across a 5 volt supply. So, what is the current out of the battery? So, what is the current out of the battery is taken as I. Now, when three equal resistors are connected, all the three are 15 ohm. Therefore, what must be the R equivalent here? R equivalent must be equal to what? This is equal to 15 by 3. 15 by 3 is equal to what? 5 ohm. Is it not? So, 15 by 3 is equal to 5 ohm. Then, what is the potential difference is 5. So, the current I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. So, this is equal to 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1 ampere. So, which of these options is the correct answer? Option A is correct. Therefore, option A is correct. Have you all understood? Okay, we will go to the next set of problems.